Hi everyone, I'm back with another League of Legends review commentary. This time I'm playing Jarvan in the jungle, and I'm versus a Zed jungle. I'm going for Bruiser Jarvan. I'm running AD Quinns, Armor Pen Reds, Armor Yellows and Magic Resistance Blues. And I like to build him with some AD, so you can dunk people. Which of course is very fun to do. Now first thing you will notice is that Zed is not really a good jungle pick. Jarvan is at the moment. He has had 3 buffs in the last few patches. And I think he is viable at least, and maybe even pretty good. But yeah, Zed isn't, so I'm gonna try and invade him early. And we will see what happens. I'm starting Hunter's Machete and a refillable potion. Hunter's Machete because the attack speed buff on Jarvan's E makes you auto-attack the camps a lot, so you get a lot of health back. And you don't really use a lot of mana, so I prefer to go with the Hunter's Machete. This game I'm playing with friends. The Vayne is my friend. Maybe see that the audio, that the video quality has gone up recently. The audio is still bad. Sorry for that. I don't have a good microphone. I'm using the one on my headset, and I'm trying to edit it a little bit so it sounds better. But it's still a low quality microphone, so. So yeah, I've cleared my my Crux and my red buff, and now I'm gonna look for Zed at his walls, but you can see him doing the river crab, so we'll not encounter him here. But I know he hasn't done his wall, so I will check his blue, and I know he has done that, so he must be on this side. And here I see him. I flash auto attack to get the red buff slow, and just finish him for the first blood. So yeah, very easy. If you think about your matchup before the game starts, you can do things like this, because I already know that Zed is gonna be low in his first clear. So yeah, I drop my flag here for the assist. If you're playing Jarvan, always drop your flag near fights where enemies are gonna die, so you can get the free assist. Gives you some extra gold. I can push in the wave here for Yasuo because he's dead. And this way Annie will lose some minions and I will gain some. So I'm already far ahead of the Zed. He still has problems clearing, probably, because he died early and it's still the first clear. I'm just securing my buffs, because I want to gank mid lane again as soon as possible. Yasuo told me in chat that Annie had used flash and their other summoner. So yeah, if someone uses flash, they are a very good target for Jarvan. If you hit your EQ, your ganks are mostly successful. But yeah, if they flash your EQ, and you don't have your ult, you have no gap closer anymore. Or you can flash yourself, but. So yeah, I saw the Annie putting a ward down. And I can gank from behind this this wall, but they are too far pushed in, so I'm gonna loop around. And he probably won't expect this, so it's a free easy gank because she doesn't have flash. Yasuo hits his EQ, and then I can hit my EQ, and then it's game over for Annie. So we put our Yasuo ahead. It's a very snowbally lane. Yasuo versus Annie. If Annie wins, then Yasuo will have a hard time because Annie can just one-shot him. But if it's the other way around, yeah, it's gonna be very hard for Annie. Our bot lane isn't doing so well, so I'm gonna try and help them a little bit. The Zyra is far overextended, so I know I'm spotted by a ward, but she's too far back. And here I make a mistake, I use my EQ. But I should have just walked up, used my shield, and then EQ. And the Vayne dies for it. So yeah, that was pretty bad, but I'm still full health, and they are both low, so I'm not giving up. Thresh is coming. So he uses his W, he can't snare me, so I can go in. Zyra misses his E. Oh yeah, that's dunked, sort of. Yeah, the exhaust from Thresh saved us, or we would have been dead. I tried to grab the lantern from Thresh, but you can't grab the lantern if your standard is next to it, I've noticed with Jarvan. It happens again later on in the game, but yeah, I don't know if that's a bug or how it's supposed to be, but yeah, I panicked a little bit there and I tried to walk away, but yeah, it was too late, so I had to turn around immediately. But I did that late as well, but because of the Thresh exhaust, we still got the kill. So another thing with Jarvan is that your EQ doesn't always do damage, but does knock people up. The reason for that is that the damage from your EQ comes from your Q, but the knock-up from your EQ comes from your character being pulled to the flag. So your character model is a little bit thicker than your Q. So sometimes you knock up people, but you don't hit the damage on them. So it's a thing to remember. I missed my EQ here very bad, but I can just dunk the Zed. Yeah, I don't think he's having a fun time. Out this jungle because we know he's dead. Then we can maybe get a gank off in the mid lane. Too late with my EQ, but the Thresh hits his Q. Should have not taken his Q. Could have killed Annie without him going in, but it's okay. It's a good trade. Support for mid laner. Warrior first. I don't like Cinderhulk on Jarvan. Most high elo players take Cinderhulk. I can switch it up later if I want, but I like the damage early, and Jarvan is especially good early. He falls off a little bit later on. I'm gonna look for Zed again in his jungle, but I see him fighting with Diana in the top lane, so I'm gonna just pick that free kill up. He does get Diana, but that's good for me because then he's worth gold again. And here I make another mistake. I ult immediately. And you can dodge Jarvan's ult now. I didn't know that until that happened, but now I know. But yeah, I had my EQ still, so I could follow him, even if he dodged my ult. And here I can push in the wave, so the Olaf misses, hopefully, the cannon minion. Yeah, I believe so. So I have a little bit of armor now. That's important for ganking the Jin because he got pretty fat. Already has a ghost blade. It's the only one I need to look out for at the moment. The Vayne wanted this camp, but she hesitated, so I just took it. Fighting going on here. Zyra flashes. I'm looking for a EQ maybe, but the Zed is an easier target, so I'm just gonna walk back and kill steal the Zed. Yeah, I don't know why he's so far in our jungle. To kill the thresh, obviously, but he's low, so he shouldn't be there. Or he's behind, so he shouldn't be there. Now here I make another mistake. I think I can kill that Zyra pretty quickly, but she has exhaust, and I later see that she has a giant belt as well, so it's more of a tank Zyra. So I should have checked that first. Could have focused. It was better to focus Jin because he's the only one that is a threat at the moment. As you can see, he can just 2v1 our bot lane. Our top lane is winning on his own, and our mid lane is winning as well because we put him ahead. So I'm buying a Randuin's Omen just so I can gank Jin better because of his guaranteed crit and the crit damage reduction on Randuin's Omen. It's pretty good for champions like that. Also very good against Yasuo, for example, or Tryndamere, Shaco, things like that. Here I try to get her with my E, but she's just out of range. Not gonna dive that because she isn't worth my shutdown. Yeah, back to clearing. Yeah, I make that mistake a lot. I EQ and I knock every monster up, but I don't hit my Q, so I miss out on damage and it takes longer to farm, so less time to gank. So I should really watch that. Use the EQ on all three or more minions. I see them here dancing around dragon, so I'm gonna walk bot lane. It would be stupid for them to do it, but you never know, so I want to be close. I see them going for the Vayne. knew he used his W, so now I could ult him immediately and he couldn't dodge. And yeah, the Vayne should have stayed in the bush until Zed ulted. Because now he had the chance to burn her heal. I don't really want to fight this, but Zyra hits everything on Thresh, so here I feel I need to go in. And yeah, with the challenging smite I can just beat down the Jhin. Dodge the Zyra E. Try to get her as well, but the exhaust fucks me up. So I pussy out. But I think I could have killed her. So my bad. I have a lot of armor, so I think I could have resisted all those minions. Because that's what I was afraid of. The minions, not really Zyra. But yeah, I still had like 200 health, so I could have stayed. So another little mistake. But we still got the Jhin, and that is of course the important target, so no biggie. Sorry about that. We see 5 people mid, so I'm gonna stay mid so they won't dive the Yasuo. But I want to go back to farming as well, because dancing around mid lane and getting nothing is it's not helping me get becoming stronger. So yeah, Diana is pushing top, so someone has to respond to that, probably the Olaf. As soon as we see him leave, we can go do a camp. And go back mid lane. We see Thresh engage. And we can get off a double ult. Get a burn kill on the Zyra. And he has had ults me, but I just walk away from his ult shadow so he can't hit double Qs, and then his ult doesn't do any damage, so I'm never really afraid of a Zed, because there's a little trick behind his ult. It's pretty simple. As soon as he reappears next to you after your ult, you just walk in a rear direction so he misses his Qs. A smart Zed will wait a second and then throw his Qs, so. But most Zeds just hurry up and throw everything out as soon as they reappear. And if you walk away, they don't expect, they miss everything. Except, of course, the E, but you can't dodge that E. Giving my blue to Diana, I don't really need it anyways. Now we're going for the Rift Herald. Yeah, I asked my Diana if I could have the Rift Herald, because yeah, I'm 10-1, but she took it anyway. Yeah, and that's pretty stupid, because I'm by far the strongest. Here we can come behind Zed. And the minions kill him. My E and the minions, so it was just enough. Another fadeaway kill, I love those. That's why I like to play Fizz, things like that. I like to play Zed as well. There's a gigantic wave in the bot lane. I'm telling my Vayne to go there because it's just too enormous to ignore. I'm doubting about taking it, but the Vayne was already here, so. As you maybe notice, I do not prioritize dragons. The reason in this game because our bot lane is just not strong. But most of the time I like to get ahead first and take dragons when there's no chance. So here we see the Zyra alone. She misses her E, so she has no way to stop me. And I can just dunk her. Barely missed my EQ. The Diana gets a nice E, triple E, gets a double kill. And my team finishes the rest. Checking if his camps are up. Placing some deep wards. I love a pink ward there. They usually stand around a long time, especially if you place them early. Now we are already in the jungle, so they might find it pretty quick. But if it's early in the game, they won't go to that bush very often. So. I have had multiple pink wards just standing there the entire game, and it gives so much information. Things like that can win you a game. I see the Zyra coming down for the Vayne. I'm hoping they are gonna chase. And as you can see, they are. I missed my EQ. It's pretty bad. But I can just dunk and red smite the Jhin. Here I make another mistake. I use my E without having a Q. So yeah, Zyra can escape. If I waited until my Q was up again, I could have chased her. Teammates are doing the dragons, so I'm gonna help them secure it. Just farming everything I see, especially in the enemy's jungle now, because I want no possibility for Zed to catch up. I also like to smite the walls, just because it gives so much vision, and it helps me here as well, because it sees the Zyra, and I know she is alone, so again, I can just dunk her. Exhaust saves her for 2 seconds, but yeah, she can't walk through walls, so.
Team's turret has been destroyed.
So yeah, just keeping up and with farm. Very important, don't forget to farm all game long. I used to do that, getting a lot of kills, getting ahead, and then trying my best to finish the game, but forgetting to farm, and it gives your enemies room to catch up, and then you still lose. I see them fighting this side of the jungle. Let's see if I can help. See, my pink ward is still there, and this is why Jarvan is good on versus Olaf. Can withstand every CC with his ult, besides the Jarvan ult. Bad engage from Thresh, but they line up for EQ. I get the triple knockup. Diana gets the double kill. Here I thought I had to help Yasuo, but I didn't need to. So I flashed for nothing. But hey, I didn't need my flash anyways. I don't really need it this game. Pushing the wave under the tower, so they miss minions. But yeah, if you can see our team comps. I was one of the last picks, I believe. And yeah, their whole team comp just shouted Jarvan. Jarvan is a counter pick to Zed. In lane, yeah, jungle of course as well, but you never see Zed in the jungle. They have 4 immobile people. Only the Zed can dodge my ult, but the rest can't, so Jarvan is just too good here. And I'm glad I picked him, because yeah, the pick helped me a lot. Champion picks are more important in the last few patches. Try to round out your team comp, because the Yasuo, Riven, Zed, Tryndamere and another AD champion team comps don't work anymore. Everyone was playing that in season 3-4. Just because they were so strong. You saw a Yi in the jungle, a Riven top, a Yasuo mid, stuff like that. But yeah, that's not possible anymore. You just get wrecked if you do that. Here I see them fighting in the mid lane. And if I get there, I can just go in immediately. I'm way too tanky for them to burst, so I can just engage whenever I want. That's what you like to see as a tank. Putting my E down for the extra attack speed, because we want to get this objective. Taking his jungle, again smiting the wolf camp for the vision. As soon as one of them enters the jungle, I have vision, and this time it's Annie. Yeah, she shouldn't be in her jungle alone. This time I engage in the right way. I walk up to her, I slow her with my shield, and then I EQ. That's one way to guarantee a hit. You can also apply red buff or wait for an ally to slow one of your enemies. Taking the Inferno Drake just because we can. Yeah, wanted to catch up on the Zed, but he's too far away, so I'm gonna look for the Olaf. I was expecting him to be in this bush. I have Red Smite, so maybe without Red Smite he could have maybe beaten me, but with Red Smite, absolutely not. And with Thresh, also there, nah. He was just dead. And yeah, my team is finishing the game here. They killed everyone else, so... no one left anymore.
Red team's turret has been destroyed.
Yeah, and that was the game. I hope you guys enjoyed it.